A very good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. In today's class, you will all appear for a practical test. You have to look at the pictures being shown to you and make all these pictures. Before you begin the test, here are some important things that you need to keep in mind. This is a practical test for all of you in which you will be shown images and you need to see them and then make the same. You will be given only 45 minutes for this test. In this test, all of you will be given a total of 4 pictures. Let us now begin the test. Now, all of you switch on your computers and open the Paint file. In today's class, the pictures that you need to make are as follows. The first picture is of a TV set. The second one is of a flower. The third one is that of a cartoon. And the fourth and the last one is of a dog. In all these pictures, the same tools have been used about which you have learned in the second module. Look at the picture being shown to you and then all of you go ahead and make this picture. Then save it with your name and date in the pictures folder on your computer. And then also show the same to your teacher. Now, all of you watch the video to know the correct method of making it. You will now watch this video and compare your answer with the correct answer, which is shown in the video, on how to make this TV. So for the TV, we are first selecting the rounded rectangle tool. Select color 1 and color 2. Let's select both as dark blue. Bring your, select the, from the fill option, select solid color. Bring your pointer to the drawing area in the paint sheet and drag this rounded rectangle to make the main face of the television. Select the color 1 and color 2, both make them black, and then drag another rounded rectangle here at the bottom to make the base of the TV. Now we need to make the switches inside this base. So we select color 1 as gray, color 2 also as gray. And then we can drag a rectangular box here like this, which represents the switches and the different options under the TV in the base. Then drag another smaller box here, rounded rectangle. Now we can select the color 2 as black, because we are going to copy paste the second box and the background is black. Go to the select option, select rectangular selection, and then select this second gray box that we have made and use copy paste, control C and control V, and then you can pick this copy and place it in the base of the TV like this. Again do a control V to paste another copy. And pick that also. Place it here. Besides the second one, like this, You would have noticed there are many switches on the TV. So that is what we are making. We can make one more copy using Control V and then pick it up and place it here like this. So this way the main part of the TV has been made in the drawing. Now we need to make the wire. So we select color 1 as black. Select the curve tool to make a curved wire, and from here downwards slanting towards the right and down, we make this curve, and you can place your pointer here and curve it upwards, place your pointer towards the bottom and curve it towards the bottom. Let's also make a small plug. So let's make the color 2 white so that we have, and let's select the rectangle tool and drag a rectangle here at the end, which is in black outline and white inside. So this is our plug. We need to make the pins of the plug. So we select a line thickness, which is the thinnest line, the first size, and then go and select the line tool and draw these small pins here on the plug as is being shown in the video. First drag here and draw a line on the top and then a small line on the bottom also like this to make the plug of the TV. So this way we can use the rounded rectangle tool to make our picture of this colorful TV. After saving the last picture, now all of you open another drawing sheet in your paint file. Look at this picture now and say, what is this called? This is a picture of a flower. Now all of you make this picture and save it in the pictures folder with your name and date and with the name as picture 2. Show this to your teacher. Watch the video to know the correct way to make this picture. We now watch this video and learn the correct method of making this leaf flower. So for this, we need to select the rectangle tool first. Select an appropriate size, the thin size, and then drag the rectangle on your drawing area in the paint sheet like this. Next, we select the curve tool. We are making color 1 black only. Select the curve tool and then drag a first curve here as is being shown in the video, and then drag it a little upwards and from here a little downwards to make the curve. Click on it. Then from here we'll drag another curve and drag it a little towards the left side like this. Left click once. Drag another curve from here like this, and from the center drag it a little downwards like this. Then click on it once. Drag another curve from here towards the right side. Double click there. Drag another curve from here going upwards towards the left side. And you can pull or drag it towards the left side also. Like this. And then left click once. One more time. Let's take a curve here going towards the right and slanting downwards drag it down and up also to make a nice curve. Click once, drag a curve here upwards, drag it towards the left side, left click it once. Let's take one more curve from here, going here like this. Then click on it once. Take one more curve from this point towards the top. This is a long curve, going towards the top into the middle. And then drag from here a little towards the right side, and from the top towards the first towards the left, then towards the right side. Now we can just copy paste this whole thing, the picture so far we have made. So use the select tool, use rectangular selection, select this portion that we have drawn, use copy paste, Control C and Control V, and then you have to place it on the other side, but also remember to flip horizontal. So go to rotate and click on flip horizontal, and then you can move it here like this. Try not to leave any gaps, because when you fill color, if there are gaps, the color will spread to the entire sheet. So place it like this. Now we have to draw the stem of the leaf. So we have to draw curves here. But remember, we have to first select the curve tool. So after selecting the curve tool, we draw this curve here. Drag it a little towards the left and from the bottom. First on the top, we are dragging it towards the right, and from the bottom towards the left. Drag another curve here like this. And do the same with this. Drag it towards the right from the top and from the bottom towards the left. And then we can just join the bottom of the stem like this. And you can also drag it a little downwards, then click on it. Next, we need to make small petals here. So we drag a curve and then drag it upwards, a little upwards here like this. Click on it, drag another curve here, join it and drag it a little downwards like this. If you don't like it, you can use undo and redraw the curve, drag it downwards like this. Now to make a similar sepal on the other side, we can just select this one that we have made, use copy paste and the flip horizontal option. So we use select, rectangular selection, select this entire small sepal or leaf. Do a copy paste by using Control C and Control V. Before placing, we have to flip horizontal. So go to rotate, select the flip horizontal, and then you can place it here like this. Now you can see there is an extra line which is there. So you'll have to use the eraser tool to erase that extra line. So we just select the eraser tool and then erase this little line here like this by using the eraser tool. We again select the curve tool and make a curve here. Drag it towards the left side like this. Make another curve like this. We're trying to make the funny eyes in the leaf. Like this here. Make another curve from this point. Like this. Drag it a little downwards here. One more curve to complete the second side or the second eye, so to say. Drag this a little upwards like this. If you want, if you are not happy with where you have made this, you can use the select tool and select these two eyes and then move it to a right position, to the center. Next, we select the brushes. We select the airbrush and we have already got the black color. So we just make one dot here and one dot on the other side to get the funny eyes. Select the curve tool. Draw a small curve here to make the smiley face. Drag it down a little from both these places and then click on it to place it properly. Then drag a small curve on the side here to make the smile complete, and you can drag this and then position it properly like this, then click on it. If again you are not happy, you can use the undo command. Draw a curve like this here and pull it towards the right side and place it properly. Now again you can use the select tool, rectangular selection, and select this little edge of the smile. Use copy paste. Use rotate to flip horizontal. And then you can pick it up and place it on the other side of the smiley face, like this. So let us now start using the colors and the airbrush or the brush tool. So we select the brushes and we select the airbrush. We select the color here, light brown. And from the size, we can select the thickest size right now because we have to fill the area. And then bring your pointer here and you can start coloring just like you would use your crayons or colors. And you can color this bottom area with the brown color. Keep the left button on your mouse or touchpad pressed and keep moving the same to fill this area with color. Remember, if you want to make the color darker, you can keep on repeating on that area and that area will become darker and darker. As is being shown in the video, you can keep moving your mouse or touchpad by dragging it. Keep the left button pressed and the color keeps becoming darker. Like this, we continue till we like the color or till we have got the color here. Now use the fill with color option. Select the dark green color and bring here and fill it. But you notice that because of some gaps there, this entire area is becoming green. So you have to see where the gap is, and you can use the pencil tool to close the gap. Use the color one as black for the pencil tool, and there was a gap here, so just close that like this. There's a gap on this side, so close that also like this. And then let's try fill with color again. We use the green color, fill with color option. And now you can see that it fills up the leaf area. This petal also we want to, or the leaf, small leaf we want to fill in green. So we've done that. Next, we go and pick the pencil tool again. We're trying to see if there is any gap on the stem side. So we use the black color. We try and fill this or close this gap using the pencil tool. And we can try to use a different color for the stem. We are selecting brown. Fill with option, fill with color option, and see if it fills the stem. But there is still some gap, so we can just leave it. We can use undo and leave it as a green color. Next, we select the yellow color and we can fill the eyes with the yellow color. We are still using the fill with color option here. Next, we select the dark green color. Let's select the brushes, the airbrush, and we make this portion here. Let's select a different size, the second size, and then draw a small plant here, greenish plant, and just use the airbrush to make these small leaves or green flowers, you can call them. Then you can use the select tool, rectangular selection, and select this little plant that we have made. Use copy paste, Control C, Control V, and then you can place it here. From the side dots, you can move them like this to resize this plant and then leave it here. You can do another copy paste. Draw it here or bring it here. If it seems to be going outside your drawing, you can always resize it from these small buttons on the sides and then place it here properly. We will continue to do Control V to paste some more copies and keep getting more of these plants here like this. One more paste, resize it to make it small, get one more plant with using the paste option, bring it here, resize it to make it a little smaller, like this. Let's take one more copy, like this. You can continue. And you can make more and more small plants, and you can always resize them to make them big or small according to your choice. This way you will complete this picture. Next, you have to make the picture of this cartoon and again save it with your name and date in the pictures folder. Show the same to your teacher. And again, to know the correct method, watch the video. Let us now watch this video and understand the correct method of making this cartoon character. For this, select the fill with color option first and select the dark blue color, so that our entire sheet is colored with this. Just bring your pointer to the drawing area in the paint sheet. Click here and it completely gets filled with the dark blue color. Now, let's select the oval tool. Change color 1 also to white. Color 2 is also white. And drag an oval here. Like this. Now remember, to make the face, we have to cut the top portion. So before we cut, we should change color to the background color, which is dark blue. Next, we go to the select option and select the rectangular selection and then choose, select the top portion and cut it using Ctrl plus X. Choose the curve option and then from this point drag a curve like this, a line upwards, and then you can drag it outwards like this from these two points and click it. And here let's drag another line, a curve. Curve using the curve tool. And then drag this upwards towards the right side and towards top. So this way we have the basic face ready for the cartoon character. Next, we have to make the ears, so we use the curve tool again. Drag a curve here, drag it upwards, and drag it down from the bottom side, so it becomes a nice curve here. Drag another curve here to make the top of the ear, and drag it upwards. And click once. Now we can select this ear by going to the select tool, selecting rectangular selection, and then we will do a copy paste and using the rotate tool to flip horizontally, we will get the right ear from this. So we use Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V to paste it. Then we use the rotate option from the select. Use transparent selection. Remember to use transparent selection from the select option. And the rotate option, use flip horizontal. And then you can pick it and place it properly so that no extra line is left. So like this, we've got both the ears. Next, we have to make the other parts of the cartoon character face. So we make both color 1 and color 2 white, select the oval and draw this eye. Then use the select option, rectangular selection, select this eye, use copy paste. Control and Control C and Control V, but you notice that the copy is not properly visible because we forgot to make the color 2 the same as the background color. So we have to go to color 2 and choose dark blue. Once again, use the rectangular selection to select the eye. Do a copy paste. Control C and Control V, and then move the second copy to make the second eye of the cartoon character. Let us change color to also again to white. Choose the oval tool. And then let's drag this oval here to make the body of the cartoon character like this. And you can move it and place it where you like it to be. Once again, we select the curve tool. We're making the feet here by dragging a curve, drag it a little upwards. Make another curve here, join it to the body, and drag it a little downwards, like this. Again, we can use the copy paste option. So remember, before we copy, the color 2 should be the background color, which is dark blue. Go to the selection tool, pick on the rectangular selection, and select this, and then use Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste. Pick this copy here, bring it here. And now rotate it using flip horizontal, and you can pick and place it here so that the second foot of the cartoon character is also made. Next, we have to make the hands in the cartoon character. So we again use the curve tool, select the curve tool. Bring a pointer here, make a curve, and then just drag it a little outwards like this. If it's not coming properly, you can undo it and draw again. Drag it like this. Make another curve here, a small curve, drag it a little downwards. And one hand gets made. Click on it. Now we can use copy paste again. So use the rectangular selection. Make sure that the color 2 is the background color dark blue. Select this. Do a Ctrl C to copy and Ctrl V to paste. Once you get the copy, pick it up and bring it here. Place it here. Let's also rotate it. So go to the rotate option, flip horizontal, and you can place it by picking it and placing it where you desire. Next, we have to make the face or the mouth portion. For that, let's make color 1, color 2 both white, and let's select the 4-point star. From here in the shapes, the 4-point star, and we just drag it here and leave it like this. Click on it. Next, we use the curve tool again. And draw this small line from the bottom of this pointed star and drag it a little upwards. Downwards, like this. You have to make another curve on the right side. So we can either use the curve tool or we can just use the copy paste. So let's make color 2 as the background color, which is dark blue. Go to the select option, select rectangular selection, and select this portion, the last curve that we have made. Ctrl C to copy, Ctrl V to paste, bring it here. But remember, we have to also rotate it. So use the rotate option, flip horizontal. Once you do flip horizontal, the second curve is available to you and you can move it and position it in the right spot to make the lips or the mouth of the cartoon character. Next, we have to make the tail. So we use the curve tool again because it's a curved tail. Draw a curve here. Move it up. Move it down like this. Make a nice curve. And let's make a thick tail. So we make another curve here. And also drag it downwards like this. And slightly upwards from here. So this way your cartoon character picture can be made. The last picture for today's test is that of a dog. Make this picture also and save it in the same way as told to you earlier. Show it to your teacher and then watch the video to check the correct way of making it. Let us now watch this video and get to know the correct way of making this picture of a dog. So first of all, select the oval tool. Select a color. Let it be black. And let's drag this oval here in the drawing area. Next, you can just select the size and choose the correct size for the oval. Now we need to cut the bottom portion of this oval which we are making the face. So we go to the select tool, select the rectangular selection and select the lower part of this oval which is going to make the face of the dog. And using Ctrl plus X, which is the shortcut for cut, we cut this part of the oval. Next, we choose the curve tool. The color is already black in color 1. And we make our first curve here by dragging. And we can drag this a little up from here and little down from here. We are making the mustaches of the dog. So we make another line or drag another curve from here to here, joining the bottom and then drag it a little downwards like this and click on the side. If you are not happy with it, you can always use the undo command to erase the last part that you have drawn and redraw it again. So we are dragging it again and now we have a nice curve, second curve for the mustache. Let us select, go to the select command and select the rectangular option. And you can now select the entire mustache that you have drawn. Do a copy paste by Ctrl C and a Ctrl V to do the paste. Go to select. First, let's go to rotate command and flip horizontal because we now want to place this mustache on the right side of the dog's face. Then we can pick it and bring it here and place it like this as is being shown in the video to you. Select the oval again. Make color 1 as black, color 2 as black. Choose solid fill and let's fill the color here. Drag an oval here. So we are dragging an oval with solid colors. Black outline, black inside also. So that is why we had chosen solid fill. Next we have to make the bottom portion. So first we make color 2 white, go to the curve command, select curve command again and draw a curve here like this and then you can pull it downwards a little bit as is being shown here to make the lower portion of the dog's face. Click on the side, So we now have the mustaches, we have the mouth. Select color 1 and color 2 as black. Go select the oval tool. And then let's drag an oval here. You have to make the eyes of the dog. Make color 2 white. And then inside this, let's make the pupils of the eye. So white dots will appear inside the eye. That is what we are making now. Go to the select command, rectangular selection, select this entire eye, and then you can do a copy paste, Control C, Control V, and bring this eye that you have just copied and place it in the face of the dog. So we place one eye in the face of the dog, then we do another copy paste and place the second eye also, as is being shown here. Now we have to make the rest of the body of the dog. Select the curve tool and from the brushes, we select one brush. Right now we are making the eyelashes on top of the eyes of the dog. So you can just drag, keep your left button pressed and drag it like you are seeing in the video to make the eyelashes or the eyebrows for the dog's eyes. So you can make it on the left eye, make it on the right eye as is being shown here. Select the curve tool once again. Remember, we still have to make the ears also. So we make a curve here, drag a curve here. Drag it upwards from the top portion, drag it downwards from the lower portion. Make another curve like this and drag it upwards like this here. Click on the side once you are happy with the curve. Go to rectangular selection, select rectangular selection. You can copy paste this area. Bring it here, but we first have to rotate it because we are making now the left portion. So flip horizontal from rotate you choose and then bring it and place it here as is being shown in the video. Once you're happy with where it is placed, you can click on the side and it will remain there. So the face portion is more or less ready. We select the curve tool again. And from here, we drag a curve downwards to make the side of the leg. One side of the leg, then we can use the curve tool to drag it slightly outwards and then slightly inwards from here. And then we are making the paws. So we drag another line from here, like this here. Little towards the right side, downwards. If you're not happy with it, you can always do an undo. So we've dragged it again and we've dragged it towards the left side now, downwards, but left side. One more line. We drag it like this, keep it here. Another line being dragged here. Keep it here. One more line we'll make from here. And drag it a little upwards towards the right side. So now we can see that the right leg is more or less ready. Now, as you know, once we have made one side of the leg or one leg, we can always use copy paste command. So we are first correcting all the curves that we want to make nicely. Once again, we go to select option, you use the rectangular selection and select the entire leg here. Then we do copy paste, control C, control V, and use flip horizontal from rotate, because now we are making the right side of the leg. So we take it here and place it like this nicely. So more or less this picture is ready. We select the curve tool, bring it here. And we need to make these curves at the bottom, which were also there in the original picture. So that's what we are doing. Small curved line here. Drag it a little upwards like this. Another curve, a third line, drag it a little upwards again. Another one here, going down, drag it towards the right side. And joining here, drag downwards. Again, you can use the select tool, use rectangular selection, select this portion that you have just made, copy paste using control C and control V, bring it after using rotate, flip horizontal, bring it, drag it and place it on the left leg or the left paw of the dog. So here, we place it. Now we only have to remove this extra eye which we had drawn. So we just select that and you can use delete command on your keyboard. So this way, the picture of the dog becomes ready. This class of the practical test will end here now. All of you close your paint file and properly shut down your computer. Next, you will all appear for a written test which all of you must pass. Because if you fail in this test, you will not be able to proceed to the next module and will need to revise this part again. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.